Federal authorities on Thursday searched the offices of a political consulting firm in Annapolis that has worked with Republican candidates locally and nationwide and was sued in 2014 on allegations of fraudulent fundraising practices. Strategic Campaign Group says it supports Republican candidates on a range of services including mail, fundraising and telephone town halls. Its leaders include GOP strategists Kelley Rogers, Chip O'Neil and Dennis Whitfield. The firm has close ties to Republican consultant Scott B. McKenzie, a treasurer for multiple political action committees that have drawn scrutiny for spending little money on candidates and instead steering donations to consultants, according to the Center for Responsive Politics. Rogers said in an interview that he helped lead one of those groups, the Conservative Strike Force. On Thursday, six FBI agents showed up at the third-floor office of Strategic Campaign Group to gather computer files and documents related to the firm's direct mail and fundraising practices, Rogers said. Lindsay Ram, a spokeswoman for the FBI field office in Washington, confirmed that agents were conducting law enforcement activity in Annapolis, off Main Street. Rogers said agents appeared interested in work the firm did during Virginia Attorney General Ken Cuccinelli's 2013 gubernatorial race. Cuccinelli, R., sued the Strategic Campaign Group and the Conservative Strike Force in 2014, alleging they raised almost $2.2 million to support his campaign but steered little of that money to him. Our suspicion is that this is just a carryover from that, Rogers said. I think the facts speak for themselves, and we tried to give the agents all the information they could possibly need. The Conservative Strike Force agreed to pay Cuccinelli $85,000 to settle the lawsuit, and Strategic Campaign Group said it would turn over donor information. The Conservative Strike Force has paid Strategic Campaign Group at least $493,000 for services since 2011. According to federal records. Strategic Campaign Group also received at least $188,000 in that time period from the Conservative Majority Fund, another political action committee listing McKenzie as its treasurer. McKenzie did not return a voicemail seeking comment. Both groups have spent a small portion of the donations they receive on the candidates they aim to support, according to federal records, and reported high spending on consultants and other firms. The Federal Election Commission has been struggling for some time with the issue of political action committees that are formed solely to enrich those running them. Unlike nonprofits, which are governed by boards of directors, PACs can be run by a single consultant. And although candidates are prohibited under federal election law from using campaign donations for personal use, traditional political action committees and their super PAC brethren face few limitations on how they spend their funds. Critics say scam PACs have proliferated in recent years, driven in part by the advent of big money super PACs in the wake of the Supreme Court's 2010 Citizens United decision. There has also been a surge in groups chasing small dollar donors, often with misleading promises of how they plan to use those funds. The Strategic Campaign Group has ties to Republicans in the Maryland state legislature, and Rogers has raised money for Governor Larry Hogan, R., although Rogers said Thursday that federal agents did not appear interested in his local work. In 2016, Strategic Campaign Group was paid by the campaigns of Maryland House Minority Leader Nicholas R. Kipke, R. Ann Arundel, and GOP Maryland congressional candidates Patrick McDonough and Charles Faddis, state and federal records show. Kipke said Thursday that the state GOP House and Senate political operations would suspend work with the company until the investigation is resolved. Strategic Campaign Group also worked to support Republican Kathy Zeliger's unsuccessful 2016 campaign for a U.S. Senate seat. Virginia Republicans, mostly state lawmakers, have sent the company more than $500,000 since 2009 for services including polling and robocalls, according to the Virginia Public Access Project. The FBI raided a Republican campaign consultant's Annapolis office Thursday, causing Maryland Republican lawmakers to say they will stop doing business with the firm. Kelley Rogers, president of Strategic Campaign Group, said half a dozen FBI agents arrived at his Main Street office about 8:30 a.m. with a warrant to search and seize records. The FBI confirmed it conducted a raid in Annapolis but would not say where. An individual carrying a backpack marked FBI was seen leaving the firm's office. Rogers, whose firm has previously worked with campaign committees for Maryland House of Delegates and Senate candidates, said the FBI investigation concerns work the firm performed during the 2013 Virginia gubernatorial campaign of former Virginia Attorney General Ken Cuccinelli, a Republican. Rogers insisted the investigation did not involve Maryland politics and that the firm had done nothing wrong. He said that if any clients want to be released from their contracts, he will free them. Maryland Republicans quickly took him up on that offer. Senate Minority Leader J.B. Jennings, of Baltimore County, and House Minority Leader Nick Kipk, of Anne Arundel County, confirmed that campaign committees for GOP senators and delegates had hired the firm to raise money and do other work before the 2017 session. Both said their committees would not use the firm again until its legal issues were resolved. "I'm shocked by what has come to light today, and we will not be working with them on any new projects until the legal process is completed and they are cleared," Kipk said just hours after the raid. Jennings said the company did satisfactory work last year but added that GOP senators haven't been in touch with the firm since the session ended last month. "I think should we hire a company, we would look elsewhere," he said. According to Rogers, his firm settled a civil suit brought by the Cuccinelli campaign after he lost the 2013 Virginia governor's race to Democrat Terry McAuliffe. Rogers said the investigation appears to stem from allegations brought in that suit. The Cuccinelli suit alleged that Strategic Campaign Group and the Associated Conservative Strike Force Political Action Committee underscore an independent group not affiliated with the candidate underscore raised about $2.2 million by assuring donors it would spend the money to help elect the GOP candidate. The suit alleged that the PAC and Strategic Campaign Group failed to follow through on promises of an extensive media campaign on Cuccinelli's behalf. Rogers said his firm settled the dispute for what he recalls as $75,000. Press accounts put the amount at $85,000. Rogers insisted Thursday that the Cuccinelli campaign claims have no merit. The GOP strategist and firm Vice President Chip O'Neil spoke to reporters while FBI agents were still working in the office Thursday. Both spoke without lawyers present. Rogers praised the professionalism of the agents and predicted the investigation would clear his name and that of the firm. "The truth shall set you free," he said. Rogers said agents arrived without notice and presented a search warrant. He said they took records and downloaded other information from the firm's computers. FBI spokeswoman Lindsay Ram said the investigation is being conducted through the Bureau's Washington field office, which has jurisdiction in the District of Columbia and Northern Virginia. She said agents from the office sometimes cross over into other jurisdictions when the entity they are investigating has offices in multiple locations. She declined to provide more details. The FBI raided a Republican campaign consultant's Annapolis office Thursday, leading Maryland Republican lawmakers to say they won't work with the firm. Kelley Rogers, president of Strategic Campaign Group, said a half dozen FBI agents arrived at his Main Street office at about 8:30 a.m. with a warrant to search and seize records. An FBI spokeswoman confirmed the agency conducted law enforcement activity along Main Street in Annapolis but would not be more specific. Agents on the scene, dressed in plain clothes, confirmed they were with the FBI but referred all other questions to a spokeswoman. They left the building shortly after 4 p.m., carrying files and a computer with them. Rogers, whose firm has worked with campaign committees for Maryland Senate and House of Delegates candidates, said the FBI investigation concerns work the firm performed during the 2013 Virginia gubernatorial campaign of former Virginia Attorney General Ken Cuccinelli, a Republican. Rogers said the investigation did not involve Maryland politics and insisted his firm had done nothing wrong, but said he would release clients from their contracts if desired. Maryland Republicans quickly distanced themselves from the firm. Both Senate Minority Leader J.B. Jennings, of Baltimore County, and House Minority Leader Nick Kipk, of Anne Arundel County, said their committees will not use the firm again until its legal issues are resolved.